Good morning, student. Today I'm going to teach you a new lesson. That is chapter 8 from the book It So Happened. And the name of the lesson is Jalebis. Isn't it a funny name? Because Jalebi is a name of a Indian sweet. It is written by Ahmad Nadeem Kasmi. This is the story of an honest boy who is carrying money in his pocket to pay his fees. Was he able to pay the fees or not? What happened to him? This I'm going to read you all in this lesson. So let's begin. Now, let me start with the background of the lesson. Now, this is a story of an honest boy who is on his way to school carrying money in his pocket to pay his fees. The boy, he is in class 5th. And this boy is the narrator and he was in 5th standard. Now, one day when he went to school with 4 rupees in his pocket because he had to pay his school fees. Now, his teacher, Ghulam Muhammad, who collected the fees, was absent. All through the day, the boy was sitting with the coins in his pocket. All through the day, the coin simply sat in his pocket. But once he walked out of the school, they began to jingle. Jingle means the sound which is made by the coins. One coin actually spoke to him to eat the hot, syrupy and fresh jalebis. So jalebi, I think everybody know that it is a kind of a sweet and it is very crispy. It is soaked in a syrup, sweet syrup, and it is the shape of the jalebis are round and round and round. So when he saw the jalebi on his way back to the school, he felt that he should have those jalebis. Now, the coin began to jingle, as I told you. One coin actually spoke to him to eat the hot, syrupy and fresh jalebis. And he felt that the coins were speaking to him. Money was meant to be spent. This was a feeling which he started felt. But the boy hesitated to spend his money because he knew that next day he had to face the fees. He knew his teacher, his class teacher was very strict, and if he will not pay the fees, then he will get punishment. So he did not bother about the coins. He walked away. But the coins were not convinced. They began to speak at the same time. The boy came to know that these coins will not let him leave because they were continuously speaking to him. So he took all the coins from his pocket and grabbed all 4 of them tight in his fist. Well, grab means he caught in his feast, and as soon as he loosened his grip, the oldest coin asked him if he did not feel like eating jalebis, and next day he was to get his scholarship also. So with that money of 4 rupees, he would pay his fees easily. When the boy heard this, he felt, yes, the coins are right. And the boy's mouth watered. But still he dared not to buy the jalebis. He was a brilliant boy and he was good in his studies. He came of a well-to-do family also, but he felt it was not right for him to eat jalebis in the middle of the bazaar, and that too with his school fees. But the coins did not give up. They persuaded the boy that they were, in fact, the coins were keen on being spent that day. So they were persuading him to buy the jalebis. The boy returned home and went inside for lunch. He wanted to control his desire for jalebis. And I think you children also like the jalebis very much. Well, what happened? Let's see. But finally, he was a small boy and he also surrendered in front of the coin. Why? Because he felt that he should also have those hot, crispy, syrupy jalebis. Well, he ran to the sweetmeat seller and bought them worth a rupees, and he got quite a lot of them. Well, seeing his uncle returning from the court, the boy ran into a lane. He ate as many jalebis as he could. Soon the boys from the neighborhood surrounded him and he started disturbing them among the children. He spent the remaining 3 rupees also on jalebis and handed them out to the children. Even some beggars came to him for the jalebis. Well, after giving the jalebi, he went near a tap and he washed his hands and mouth. After washing his hands and mouth, he returned back to his home. He felt it was difficult to digest such a lot jalebi which he had taken. All night he suffered from an stomach ache. In the morning he was all right and headed for school. Now he faced another problem. And this problem had really troubled him. Because as I told you earlier, the boy bought the jalebis because he knew that he would be getting his scholarship the next day, and from that money he would take only 4 rupees to pay his fees. But now he came to know the scholarship was to be paid the next month or the following month. His head began to spin. When the recess bell rang, he knew that after this the teacher will come and collect the school fees. He was so scared that he left the school and reached the railway station. He was sad and scared, children. He don't know how to face his teacher and what he will tell to his parents, because they had already given his fees and they thought that he must have paid the fees. And if he knew that the delay in the payment of scholarship money, he would never have spent that amount on jalebis. Well, spending fees amount on jalebis is now becoming heavy on him. He thought of the teacher's cane, he thought of the teacher punishment, he thought of the teacher's words. He became helpless. He began to pray. He recited the entire namaz to please Allah. He felt sorry and appealed to God to send him 4 rupees. But all his plans misfired and failed. Allah Mia showed no mercy. One day he was caught. The report of his absence from school had reached home also, and it took him several years to realize that God helps those who help themselves. God doesn't give anything if one asks for it. This was a feeling he started feeling now. One should be careful about one's behavior. He should know that whatever he is doing correctly or not. It is up to the mark or not. Like he had spent all his money to buy the jalebis, and finally, next day when he went to the school, what happened with him? Yes, he came to know that the scholarship money he would be getting the next day. So now, children, I have completed the background of the story also, and now I will start with the lesson. Well, we will read all the 3 points which is here. First, an honest boy is on his way to school carrying money in his pocket to pay the school fees. Second, the sight of crisp syrupy jalebis in the market excites him, and the coin in his pocket begin to jingle. Third, after a long debate with himself, he yields to the sweet temptation. That means he wanted to have jalebi. Now I will be reading the lesson and I will be explaining the lesson. Now let's read. So I will be reading and I will be explaining it. Well, now children, the first paragraph. It happened many years ago. I was in the 5th standard at the government school. So children, he was in which standard? He was in 5th standard and in the government school. What was the name of the place? Let's read now. Kambalpur, now called Attock. So Attock, he was in Attock, and which was earlier known as Kambalpur. Now one day I went to school with 4 rupees in my pocket. So one day he went to the school and with 4 rupees in his pocket. And children, wow, that was for his fees, that 4 rupees. And at that time the money value was very down, but definitely it was equal to the money which we are paying it now. So that money, it was his, which was in his pocket, it was his school fees. And the fund. Now Master Ghulam Muhammad was on leave. Now children, when I got there, I found that the teacher who collected the fund, the fees, he was Master Ghulam Muhammad. He was on leave, and the fees would be collected the next day. So what happened, children? When he went to the school, the money in his pocket and how much amount was there? It was only 4 rupees. And when he went to the school, he found that his teacher, who was supposed to collect the fees, the name of the teacher is Master Ghulam Muhammad. He was on leave. And so the fees was to be collected the next day. All through the day, the coin simply sat in my pocket. Now children, the coin, it was there in his pocket. But once school got over and I was outside, they began to speak. So what happened? The coins, when he was in the school, when he was speaking, it was not jingling. But as soon as he came out of the school, okay, what happened? When he got over, the school got over and he was outside the school, the coin began to speak. All right, coins don't talk, they jingle or go khanak khanak. Now khanak khanak is a jingling sound of the coin. Okay, now children is telling, the narrator is telling, well, coin don't speak like us, but they do speak. And how do they speak? They jingle or go khanak khanak. Khanak khanak is a sound made by, it is a jingling sound of the coin. But I am telling you that did they actually spoke. Now the narrator is telling, but that day they really spoke to him. One coin said, what are you thinking about? Those fresh hot jalebis coming out of the kadhao in the shop over there. Now children, when he was coming from his school to his home, okay, one of the coin actually spoke to him. And what he spoke? Yes, he spoke that, what are you thinking about? Those fresh hot jalebis coming out of the kadhao in the shop over there, they are not coming out for nothing. Jalebis are meant to be eaten, and only those with money. So he is telling, that coin is telling to the boy that, what are you thinking? We are supposed to be spent, and money is going, this money is you spent on jalebis, and eat those jalebis, enjoy those jalebis. And only those with money in their pocket can eat them. Now he's saying nobody else can eat them. Only those people who are having money in their pocket, only those people can eat them. And money is not for, and money isn't for nothing. Now he's telling, money is not for nothing. It is simply for spending. So money mean to be spent. Money is mean to be spent only when only they spend it, and it they are supposed to be spent. Who liked jalebis? And the money, they told you that you should spend us because you like jalebis very much. Look here, you 4 rupees, I said to them. I am a good boy. Don't misguide me or it won't be good for you. Now this boy told him that I am a good boy, so please don't tempt me, don't misguide me to spend you all, because I have kept that for my school fees. So he is telling that I don't like to be spent, because this money, these you people are there in my pocket, because I have to pay the school fees. And I am a good boy. I got so much Now he said, don't misguide me or it won't be good for you. I get so much at home that I considered even looking at something in the bazaar is sin. Now the child is telling you that everybody, whatever I feel like eating, everything I am getting in my home. So it doesn't look nice that I should eat in the market because I feel it is a sin. When my parents are providing me anything, in everything in my house, then why should I eat myself in the market, in the bazaar? Bazaar is a market, okay. And he is thinking that it is a sin to eat in the market without taking permission from his parents, without making aware to the elders that he is eating in the market, because he gets everything in his house. Besides, you are my, and then the boy spoke to them, and besides that, you are my feast, that you are not a money for spending and to buy the jalebis, you are my feast. That means I have to pay you as my fees and fund money. If I spend you today, then how shall I show my face to Master Ghulam Muhammad? Now he's telling that besides you have my fees and fund money, if I spend you today, how shall I show my face to Master Ghulam Muhammad? Now children, this is the name of the teacher, and he was the one who is supposed to collect the money. So the boy is telling him, if I will pay the fees, if I will spend you all to buy the jalebis, then how I would be paying my fees to Master Ghulam Muhammad? And how I'm going to show my face to him in the school tomorrow, and after that to Allah Mia. He's telling that I cannot do that because I have to show my face to my master in the school also, and also I have to face Allah Mia. That means his was a Muslim person. He used to believe in Allah, so he's telling ki how Allah Mia is Allah, Almighty Allah, and he is a God. So he is telling that how I'm going to show my face to Allah Mia at Qayamat. Now Qayamat, I think children, you should know about this word. First of all, this is not an English word. Qayamat means the punishment given by the God according to the day. It is believed the Qayamat is the last day where all human being will be getting punishment by the God according to their deeds. So he's telling ki if I will do wrong thing, I cannot show my face not only to my master Ghulam Muhammad but to Allah Mia also, and the day of Qayamat. You probably don't know it, but when Master Ghulam Muhammad gets angry and makes you stand on the bench, he simply forgets to let you sit till the last bell ring. Now he also shared this thing that if Ghulam Muhammad will be angry, so he will not let you sit till the last period. Till the last period, you and whole period till the last bell ring. So it is best you stop chewing at my ears like this and let me go home straight. So he is telling to the coin, the boy chewing like this means he is telling to the boy that no, it is no use talking to me like that, and let me go straight to my home. And he is thinking otherwise he won't be able to show his face to his master and of course to Allah Mia at the time of Qiyamah. The coin disliked what I had said so much that all of them began to speak at the same time. Now children, all the coins, they were very angry. They did not like what the boy said to them, and they started speaking to him at the same time. That means all the coins spoke at the same time. There was such a clamor that passers-by in the bazaar stared. Now clamor, as you can see here, clamor means loud noise. So children, there was so much loud noise when they were speaking. They were shouting, okay, that everybody started in the market, everybody started looking to him. There was so much a clamor that passers-by in the bazaar stared at him. Staring means looking at him, and clamored means loud noise. Eyes wide with surprise, and they were very much surprised because they have not seen coins talking at me and my pocket. So sometimes they were looking at his face and sometimes they were looking at his pocket. The coin of those days, the wretched thing, made so much more noise too. Now children, that time coin, they started making more noise. Why children? Because they were heavy, and some of the coins were made of copper also. So finally, in a panic, I grabbed all four of them and held them tied in my fist, and then they were silent. Now what did the boy do? He took all the four coins from his pocket and grabbed them in his fist, and then the coins became silent. Now, after taking a few steps, I loosened my grip. Now children, he held the coin tightly in his feet, the boys, because they were disturbing him. They were speaking very loudly, and I told you that everybody in the market started looking at them. Well, I loosened my grip. Loosened means that the fist became loose, and grip is hold. Immediately, the oldest coin said, "Here we are trying to tell you something for your own good, and you trying to strangle us instead." Strangle means to kill by squeezing the neck. So one of the coin spoke, the oldest coin, he told, "I am telling for your benefit. I am telling you that you should spend us to have a nice crispy jalebi, and instead what are you doing? You are strangling us." Strangling us means killing by squeezing the neck. "Tell me honestly now, don't you feel like eating those hot jalebis?" Now he's telling, "Don't you feel like eating those hot jalebis? And then if you do end up spending us for today, won't you get the scholarship money tomorrow?" Now the coin gave him a great idea to him. They told him that, "Tell me one thing honestly, if you will spend us and if you will buy those hot jalebis, then tomorrow you will be getting your scholarship money also, and you can pay your fees from that money. Sweets with the fees money, fees with the scholarship money, end of story. Kissa khatam, paisa hazam." Now children, the coin started telling him that first of all, you will get the scholarship money the next day, and you can pay your fees from there. So instead of killing your desire, you should spend us and have those hot and crispy syrupy jalebis. And he is telling, now the boy started thinking, sweets with the fees money, fees with the scholarship. Now he's telling, "I would like," what they told this coin to the boy, "that you buy the sweets with the fees money, and the fees you will pay from the scholarship money, and everything will be all right. End of the story, and will be good. Okay, all well when the end is well, we all know. And in this way, the coin told, kissa khatam, paisa hazam. Okay, so with this word, I end my video here. The first part of this video is completed here. And tomorrow, I will be explaining the rest of the part. So thank you and have a nice day ahead.